Hey guys, Phonic Arts here. I have some good news for you. Since RuneScape 3 has been revealed on when its official launch date is, which is July 22nd, which is a Monday 2 weeks from now, good news is I can now start doing quest guides again because they are actually bringing a new audio engine in with the orchestrated music. I can now start doing quest guides again, which was put on hiatus like a month or two ago, so I could actually wait for it, and I apologize that it's been a wait, and I hope y'all haven't been too upset with that kind of wait. But with this, it comes with the HTML5 game client, which I won't lie, it's not in the best of its own opinion, but it's nothing I can do right now other than just provide feedback and play on it. So it's coming with the audio engine. And they're also revamping the high scores, coming with a new website look and everything. So that's going to be the good thing. They're also implementing the new interface system with it. They've upgraded the camera. And, you know, like I said, they redid the website. And they're also going to do divination, which will be released a few weeks after their launch. Which means it's going to be a great thing. But to be well prepared, you're going to have Google Chrome for HTML5, play The World Wakes and do the God Emissaries, and watch the Origins of Gilinor little motion comic that JX did, just so you're up to date on the lore and everything coming up to RuneScape 3, why RuneScape 3 is and all. You can get involved with the HTML5 beta, so that is one thing I do want you to at least try, is just, if you have to play it on lowest graphics, just get on there, run around, see what happens. If you crash, submit bug reports. That's the only thing you can really do, and it would make it a lot better. So, really, I can't say much more other than the fact that I'm looking forward to it, and I'm actually looking forward to finally being able to do quest guides again. One thing I did want to point out is, if you see RuneScape 3 in their behind-the-scenes videos, it looks entirely different than what we actually get. Which I find odd because, you know, I believe their product that they use in their videos is much further ahead than the one we have. But they're pushing out patches, small updates, time after time because, not to mention, they've got to run Java and HTML5 side by side there on their own servers. So I can assume that with that, it would actually be a little bit of a strain on their servers. So what I can run from there is pretty much just it's going to get more updates and such, and I'm hoping the final product will look better, similar to what they have in their actual videos, because I mean they're in their videos it looks good. Let's not lie, it does look good. There are things that can be updated, such as let's see, Orb of Oculus needs to finally be able to be used again. I mean it sucks trying to make YouTube banners when I can't actually take a good screenshot in HTML5 without having my characters plastered right in the middle of it, and it really bugs me because I have to use a different font style than I'd want to and actually plaster it over my character in just a way, and sometimes it's just little things like that can get really annoying. But hopefully on July 22nd it'll be a good update. If you cannot run HTML5, like you do not have WebGL because your computer cannot support it, then do not worry because you will still have the Java client. And in that sense, if you want to try that, you'd need to go to the Java Alpha. Well, no, it's not an Alpha now, it is a Beta. But go into the Java Beta now, and you'll be able to just play around in there. I mean, they have been doing patches on that consistently. So just go on there and just get a feel for it. The only difference between HTML5 beta and the Java interface beta is the fact that the interface beta is completely separate from the live game, so XP gained over there doesn't affect your live game, which is probably why most people haven't really tried it, similar to the Evolution of Combat beta. On the other hand, people who've tried HTML5 at least do get XP in the live game because it is on the live game servers. So I can see in a sense that it kind of bothers people. But when they, I'm assuming next week that they'll try to combine the interface alpha and the HTML5 beta just so we can, well, the HTML5 beta and the interface beta. I'm so used to calling it the interface alpha because it was in alpha stage for like a month. But hopefully it will look good. And I'm hoping they didn't try to rush it to get it out just so they can get Divination out before August. Which, even then, I don't think it's actually going to be before August. But I know they're trying to they're working hard on it. Which is why the months behind the scenes was actually quite small. I know people are raging about it, but, you know, you can't do nothing about it. They actually pulled out 4 updates last month, which was surprising. They had 2 that was for sure, and then they had 2 that were proposed. Well, now they've got 2 that are for certain, and 1 that's proposed, which is now going to be certain, which was RuneScape 3, and I'm not sure about if they're going to have... I think the 4th week is going to be an off week, just so they can do patches for bug issues and stuff like that. But overall, I'm looking forward to it because I can't wait to get back to doing quest guides again. I know y'all have been missing them, and I've been missing making them and producing that, you know, the quality content that I pretty much started this channel with. I mean, it sucked trying to think of content to do in the meantime, which is why there's been a lack of videos, but even then, I've been busy with school anyhow, so it's kind of ate up the time that I could use anyhow. I have produced 2 guides during that time, which is Tormented Demons and Glacors, which has been an updated version, and pretty much nothing really else other than an occasional Let's Start Maxing, because I hardly have time to stay in game and train. If I do, it's not much more than like 0.5 mil XP a day, and even then, it's not much in that sense by itself. I mean, you could gain 3-4 mil XP a day, but for me, I get quite bored, and I've been trying to get into doing things to expand this channel. I mean, I can't stick with just one thing, because if it dies, they pull the plug on it, and, you know, if Jagex pulls the plug on RuneScape and moves over to Transformers Universe only, which is doubtful, but, you know, I'm going to run out of content eventually, and then I've got to find something to do. I mean, we've got Darden doing PVM, we've got Smokey doing a generalization of updates, and, you know, his test lab along with that. Raji doing bot killing stuff, and Omar, when he actually is able to, he does updates and all. But overall, it's going to be something interesting, and I'm going to put this idea out there, but don't count on it for certain. But what would you think about a patch notes video per week? If they have patch notes on a week, it's similar to what Majin Vegito 3 did, but he's been so busy between his real life stuff and I'm assuming Rudin's own work, he hasn't had time to make videos in, what was it, 3-4 months now? But that aside, I hope you actually enjoy the content I put out, and I'm going to work on making a new trailer intro. I want to make a new intro for my videos to mix it up a little bit. I'll still use the one with Calfight King, but things are changing over time, and I want to get up to date. I mean, I have that new outro image, which actually was which ironically, the outro image you've seen on like the Tormented Demons guide and the Let's Start Maxing video a while back was actually something I made for Twitch. I made it as a skin to use streaming. But the thumbnails that I usually do with the three video outro thing actually was, I deleted all the old thumbnails, including the Let's Start Maxing, which is why it changed. Why that actual thumbnail changed, because I didn't realize it until too late. So what I'm ending up doing was I just threw that on there and used it. But it's I kind of like how it looks anyway, because it has my icon in there. So, I mean, it can't be yanked or used. I mean, it's got my name in there anyhow, so it's not like you can yank and use it without me noticing. And even then, I just gotta do what I have to do. There's not really much I can do about it. Just video-wise, it's something I've got to get done. But I think I've rambled on far enough, so I hope you've enjoyed, and I will see y'all in the upcoming weeks with a quest guide. I'll look through, train some skills on my quest noob, and I'll find out what quest I'm going to do first, and I'll be sure to make it within the week of HTML5 and all coming out, as long as the final product is actually good. So I hope you enjoy, and I will see you guys next time.